Maybe we can compete on some sort of like duo, like work together cooking show.
I would love that. I would just be dragging you down.
Do you know how fast I would get competitive and start screaming at you? I would get this close to your ear and be like, you are not going to f*** this up for me. Hi, it's me, Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
And today we have the very distinct holiday pleasure of watching the Great British Baking Show Holiday.
Baking is cool. Do you bake?
I have never turned on my oven.
Sometimes for heat at night, you'll turn it on. And that's nice. Now, spoiler alert, there might be some British people and some baking and some holidays, and I don't want to ruin any of that for you, so.
Would you go on the show?
I think you and I are more of a nailed it category. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I would love to, but with the knowledge that no matter how hard I tried or prepared, everything I made would come out total.
Or at the last second, like no matter what you do, they swap your dish for like the display dish. And you're like, and what? Sorry about it. Good luck.
As the cast of the hit sitcom The Derry Girls have descended on the tent.
We've got the cast of Derry Girls. We've got Nicola and Callum.
Callum.
I feel like in the UK, everybody's named Callum and Gemma. Literally, I have like 10 guys in the UK, and I swear to God, they're always named Callum. Swear to God. Hi, what's your... Let me guess. You're Callum.
My name's Callum.
Get in the car, you know? Let's just get this going.
I woke up this morning, I had a feeling something terrible was going to happen, and also that essentially deep down, I'm quite an evil person.
Called a hangover, Claire. You'll be grand.
They seem like wild hoes. I bet they're a lot of fun.
Yeah, the Derry Girls seem like they'd be fun to go out with.
Fun at a party. Turn fucking lit.
I'm pretty nervous, but at the same time, I'm like, a savage. Come on.
Like, what? Yeah. Like at the end, you just stop talking.
I'm pretty nervous, yeah. But at the same time, I'm savage.
I've got to mess it up, guys.
Yeah. You know what, though? Hot people do that. Hot people, words are so optional.
Judges would like you to make a large sharing trifle.
Trifling? Girl, everybody in my life is trifling.
Trifle? No, what is it?
I have no idea.
I guess we'll find out.
I hope they say trifle and one of these girls just starts pouring straight booze into a bowl. It's like a WAP, right? Like, we all just put fruit in it? Okay, great. By the way, the hair on this show is all different journeys. It looks like everybody's showing up to a different show that day.
You have 2.5 hours.
On your marks.
Get set.
Get set.
Trifle is one of those classic...
Oh, who is that? I've just been informed that the hot judge's name is Paul Hollywood. Which means he's done porn. He's done pornography. She's struggling.
The perfect texture.
I love her with that scarf. Old woman, fun glasses. Is she like the Martha Stewart of the UK? Did she go to prison? Did she do time?
And of course, the other key is a good deal of sherry or brandy or whatever they like.
Always back to the booze with these people.
Is every activity in the UK just an excuse to drink?
They're not being dehydrated by sunlight. They need something else.
Get 1 minute.
It's really hard, Bake-Off. It's really, really hard.
Oh my God. Hot teen celebrities having to do something for themselves for once.
Oh, I know.
It could have been a bowl of cereal and they would have been like, I can't believe this is going on.
The Derry Girls' trifles will now face the judgment of Paul and Prue. Oh.
Let's have a look, shall we?
Oh God.
What are British people doing with food? We're gonna take these raw ingredients and we're just gonna ruin them. That's literally everything.
That's horrible. That looks so gross.
Oh God, they're gonna hate it.
I think that tastes amazing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Very good.
That literally looks like sour cream and like green chiles or something.
It looks like a dip.
I mean, I think it is a bit of a mess.
Wait until you try it. You're gonna lick it and you're gonna lick her all over. Irish liquor all over.
Jesus. She's talking to him like I would be. And when you finish that spoon, you're gonna lick this spoon until I'm cross-eyed, bitch.
You're gonna lick this clean.
I do think it's delicious.
They hate her for it.
Just the right amount to lift.
They're all shocked.
And the textures are spot on.
Thank you so much.
They're pissed.
I'm livid.
I'm absolutely fuming. I'm absolutely f***ing fuming. Cool. Wow. See, that looks good. It's don't you think? It's like a cake with pudding on it.
I hope it's not too stiff.
Ooh-ah.
What is ooh-ah? Does he know words? How does he do acting? It looks beautiful. It looks lovely. I love the layers.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
What an adorable, beautiful little man.
You did a great job. I like this show. This is very chill. Chill energies.
Yeah, good vibes only.
This is a little more like everybody can bake. If this was American, it would be like, only one of you will be leaving with your life.
Yes,
you know.
Seriously.
Today we'll have to make a blood sausage using blood from your daughter.
And they just slit her throat right on TV.
And you scramble to the ground to catch the blood.
To catch the blood.
Yeah. You're trying to scoop it into a glass.
They're making salmon and beetroot blinis, which are like pancakes with, into the technical
blind. Hello, bakers. It's time for your technical
I love him. He has the best older goth fashion. 100%. By the way, there's nothing kind of sexier than like an older goth guy who still likes to put on a little, you know what I mean? I might not be 19 wearing eyeliner anymore, but guess what? I'm a goth bitch. Like, I hope he wears like a little boot with a heel, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think he does.
I hope so.
Prue, any words of advice?
Do as you're told.
And you won't die.
Why have you chosen blinis?
This is just such a nice dish for New Year. Cream cheese, beetroot, and horseradish.
Is this crazy? Because this looks crazy.
This is crazy.
Today we're making Ritz crackers with toothpaste and bubblegum. Oof. Me up. Literally, Michael Myers choked me out, stick a knife up my ass. I don't want to live. I don't want to make it through it. How did she die? Paul Hollywood dicked her down until her eyeballs popped out of her skull. And she's dead now. She died doing what she loved.
Now all the contestants are rushing to finish the show of their nasty blinis to the judges.
Please bring your blinis and place them behind your photograph on the table.
Holy
I'm a vegetarian. I wouldn't even be able to taste the food. They would be tasting this and I would just be like...
You're a bit irregular inside.
Panicked. Because I know they're going to hate it. I'd be leaving. Yeah.
Who's this? They are both underbrowned and yet slightly overcooked.
Well done.
Everything you've done is completely incorrect.
Which means that...
It's so delightful.
It is very joyous and so like, no, you were great. No, you were great. If these were drag queens, somebody would have hit someone on me. You'd have a girl lighting a cigarette on the open flame, someone drying weed in the oven, someone just doing some stretches with headphones in the back, and then somebody like me, a nerd, being like, you guys need to take this more seriously.
Oh, wow. Okay, so for the final showstopper challenge, they have to make a cake based on their favorite decade.
Showstopper challenge. You excited? Now, as we slip towards...
Are you excited? These people are weird. Are you excited?
The judges would like you to make a cake based on your favorite decade.
Oh, I like the 60s.
I like the 60s.
Yeah, the 1860s. So
they're doing bits. Workshop it. Take it down to the Comedy Store and do a little 10-minute slot. See how it goes.
My cake is 60s campervan, kind of summer love.
Dylan's decade cake will be made up of a hill made from Victoria's sponge.
Why don't you come over to my house? They got a nice... What? We found out he doesn't speak. Why do I have to use words? I can just use sounds.
Yes.
Which obviously you're making.
Oh, I'm not making lemon curd.
And are you making jam?
I'm not making the jam.
What exactly are you making?
I love that he said, I'm not doing none of this, but I'm going to be here while it happens. That's hot people, though. Hot people are like, I'm going to win this cooking competition by not cooking.
Go on, girl, give us nothing.
What are you going to be doing while you're supposed to be cooking? He's like, modeling. I'm going to be modeling. If you had to make a cake based on your favorite decade, which decade are you picking?
Maybe like the 70s.
Oh, put weed in it?
Just put a bunch of cocaine on it or something. Or cocaine frosting. I guess that would be the 80s.
I want them to cut into one of the cakes and be like, well, my dad was incarcerated in the 90s, so there's actually a razor blade in that one. I'd probably do the 60s, or actually, you know what? I feel like if you're gonna do a dessert, do 50s because you can go so off the f***ing rails and weird with it. Because those desserts look crazy. Neon orange turkey.
Hot dog cupcakes.
With yellow pineapple stuck to it, weird like that. We're like, what are you doing? All right, so the Derry Girls present their showstoppers to the judges. I have to say, give credit where it's due. These are non-bakers, and I think they're doing a f***ing good job.
Yeah, they're incredible.
Yeah, I'm gonna take back. Wait a minute. Is that an Amelia Earhart little head? Deep into that. It looks like a crashed plane.
The plane is sitting quite deep into that.
Because it crashed.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
That's incredible.
It's an Amelia Earhart crashed plane.
It looks like a little Easter egg.
The funding is really big.
That's fantastic. Oh, wait a minute.
Wasn't that supposed to be tie-dye?
Yeah, it was supposed to be tie-dye.
It looks like a gravestone.
Oh!
Oh my god. Baking is hard.
I know.
And they're
know,
not making simple sh- If one of them did a simple looking cake and made it taste the best, you could probably win.
Yeah.
Rather than present something that looks crazy.
But the colours are a little bit washed out.
What's the metaphor? Because peace isn't always what you imagine it to be.
Really?
Okay. Okay. You know what we're going to do today? Here's what we're not going to do. We're not going to make up stories. We're not going to make excuses. Just say you were in the cake, Mary.
Oh, does it taste good?
I think your cake is delicious.
Oh. Well done, Saoirse.
Thank you very much. Is that a bowler hat?
Yeah.
That bowler hat. It looks like a big turtle.
You know what I would do? I would go big. They would go, what is that? I would go, you know, when I'm baking, I like to put on a show, and I would grab the fondant hat. Do you want to have fun? I mean, that hat looks...
It looks like a helmet of a fallen soldier.
Like, oh my God, completely. This looks like a helmet after a blast. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, seriously.
Well, what's in that cake?
Cocoa powder.
And coffee. I do like the design, and you have gone to a lot of effort to create...
Are you kidding me with this?
...around the outside as well.
They need to have me in the show. I need to come in and, like, balance out the energy. I think the cake tastes like coffee, and it doesn't even taste like chocolate. It looks like, but you're wonderful, and your whole family's wonderful. And I'd be like... her. And if he doesn't unload in me in about 8 minutes, I'm leaving. I'm leaving. Hall of Hollywood, get over here. He would walk into this pink 60s paradise and his pants would drop and that 12-inch uncut thing would roll out on the floor and it would be over. It would be over. It would be over. I'd throw it over my shoulders like a mink stole and I'd do a number, frankly. God, I'm so gross.
You're gonna get gay rights taken away from all of us.
I know. I would love to judge a baking show.
I would love to judge.
This is what's gonna happen. They're gonna do an episode where they have to cook for a same-sex couple, and you and I are gonna judge the gay wedding cakes.
Yeah, points off for any choreography done.
Yes, please. If you at all feel the urge in a wedding proposal to incorporate choreography or a costume change, you've gone too far.
Too far.
Oh, wow.
What the f- is that?
This is my rendition of the happiest time of my life. The 1980s. Camping holidays with my family down in Westport.
Like,
this is so weird.
This is my rendition. Oh, my God. Look at it.
It's so nasty.
What if it tastes amazing? Who knows?
I know it's going to taste amazing.
Paul Hollywood is so hot. The way he looks at these people when he's judging their cakes, he looks like he's just so sexual.
Yeah, it's really good.
I'm trying to empty out a custard into a bowl, walk by and slip me the finger, Paul.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to see who wins. Now, this is the UK, so I believe they win literally a hug.
Oh, the Derry Girls.
What worries me is blood appears to be spurting out of Amelia Earhart's neck.
And she has just crashed.
I think...
look at the smile.
Love it.
Really well.
So good.
I don't think we've ever had more fun. Oh. Thank you for the crack.
Thank you for the crack.
The crack, the good time.
And by the way, thank you for the crack.
You're all winners in my eyes, but there can only be one real winner. And the winner is... Saoirse.
Oh!
If you can read, you can bake.
Way to make some of us feel very excluded.
Wait, why did... Oh, because instruction.
Yeah.
Okay.
The show's got ovens, scarves, glasses, dairy girls.
Irishmen, Englishmen.
Hot old daddies.
Bleeding historical figures in grass.
Yes. So tune into the Great British Baking Show, Holidays, on Netflix.